voice with great animation. "Then shall the king's law be law of mercy from this day, and never more be law of blood. Up from thy knees and away to the tower, and say the king decrees the Duke of Norfolk shall not die." Footnote: the Duke of Norfolk's narrow escape. Had Henry the Eighth survived a few hours longer, his order for the Duke's execution would have been carried into effect. But news being carried to the tower that the king himself had expired that night, the lieutenant deferred obeying the warrant, and it was not thought advisable by the council to begin a new reign by the death of the greatest nobleman in the kingdom, who had been condemned by a sentence so unjust and tyrannical. Hume's History of England, Volume 3, page 307. End of footnote. The words were caught up and carried eagerly from lip to lip far and wide over the hall, and as Hertford hurried from the presence, another prodigious shout burst forth. "The reign of blood is ended! Long live Edward, King of England!" End of chapter 11. The Prince and the Pauper by Mark Twain. Chapter 12. The Prince and His Deliverer. As soon as Mile Hendon and the little prince were clear of the mob, they struck down through back lanes and alleys toward the river. Their way was unobstructed until they approached London Bridge. Then they ploughed into the multitude again, Hendon keeping a fast grip upon the prince's, no, the king's, wrist. The tremendous news was already abroad, and the boy learned it from a thousand voices at once. The king is dead. The tidings struck a chill to the heart of the poor little waif, and sent a shudder through his frame. He realized the greatness of his loss, and was filled with a bitter grief, for the grim tyrant who had been such a terror to others had always been gentle with him. The tears sprung to his eyes, and blurred all objects. For an instant he